afternoon, everybody, and thank you for inviting me to talk to you today. I'm going to talk about what Heart Research UK does in the area of aortic dissection. We have three main activities. We run masterclasses in aortic arch surgery. We've funded an aortic surgery fellowship, and we've funded a medical research project. So I want to start by telling you about our masterclasses. 5 years ago, we decided to introduce masterclasses for clinicians, which was something completely new for the charity. So why did we do this? Well, we talked to lots of cardiologists, surgeons, and other health professionals, and we discovered that there are gaps in the education and training of clinicians. So our masterclasses are designed to fill some of these gaps. So they give clinicians the opportunity to learn the best techniques and the latest treatments from the leading experts. And we want them to take the new knowledge and skills back to their own centres around the UK. We believe that it is a very good use of the charity's money because of the immediate and tangible benefits to patients. An important feature of our masterclasses is that they are unique, with nothing else quite like it available in the country. So, why were we interested in aortic arch surgery? Well, we recognised that there was a lack of well-trained surgeons who were able to carry out this type of operation. It's difficult to train in aortic arch surgery, and that's because it's highly specialised and complex, and due to the small numbers of patients. The majority of cardiac surgeons will rarely see this type of surgery unless they work in a specialist centre like Liverpool. So they may never see the technique used until they have to do it in an emergency. We wanted to form a partnership with the aortic surgery team here in Liverpool, and that's because it's recognised as one of the leading centres in aortic surgery in the UK. The courses were held nearby at the University of Liverpool. So our expert masterclass faculty was led by the team of Liverpool surgeons, with Professor Ong U and Debbie Harrington as course directors. As well as the Liverpool team, we've also been joined by expert surgeons from other centres in the UK, including Castle Hill Hospital, Northern General Hospital, the Queen Elizabeth Hospital, and Derriford Hospital. We've also had renowned surgeons from Bologna, Hanover, and Paris join us. Now, it's really important to have the leading experts, and we're really grateful for their support. So they've given up their valuable time to share their expertise with other surgeons. So, what do the surgeons learn at the masterclasses? Well, they start off with presentations about the surgical technique, and then they get the opportunity to put what they have learned into practice. The most important part of the course is the hands-on practical sessions, where they learn how to carry out total aortic arch replacement. So what they do is remove the diseased part of the aorta, in this case the aortic arch, and replace it with an artificial blood vessel or graft. This is performed with one-to-one expert guidance of a faculty member. And they practice the technique using human cadavers because this is the most realistic situation and the best way to learn. I'm pleased to tell you that so far 37 consultant and trainee cardiothoracic surgeons have been trained in this important surgical technique through our masterclasses. And the map shows you where these surgeons are based. And you can see that they're from all over the UK, including Wales and Scotland. Some have travelled from as far as Plymouth, Brighton, Cambridge, Edinburgh. So you can see that we're really covering the whole country. So our masterclasses have been very popular and successful, and we've held three so far. We've got another one planned for later this year. And we're also having some discussions about holding another more advanced course in 2018. I think this is a reflection of our expert faculty, and also all the courses have been accredited by the Royal College of Surgeons. So patients across the country will benefit as more surgeons gain the expertise to carry out this life-saving operation. Each masterclass costs £25,000, and I want to take this opportunity to thank our AD supporters for working so hard to raise the funds for our masterclasses. So our supporters raised enough money to cover the entire cost of last year's masterclass, and they're well on the way to raising funds for this year's course, so thank you. So we think that our masterclasses are very worthwhile, and I just want to take a minute to share with you some of the feedback that we've had from delegates. I won't read them all out, but I just want to highlight two or three of these comments. So the first one said, "A fantastic opportunity and will undoubtedly make me more confident now to take on such cases." Another one said, "Excellent hands-on course on aortic arch replacement from a distinguished faculty, and excellent opportunity to learn life-saving operations." So another HRU activity relating to aortic dissection is the aortic surgery fellowship, and here we have Omar. You've already heard from Omar, so I won't say very much about it. But last year, Heart Research UK funded a 12-month fellowship at Liverpool Heart and Chest Hospital. So this gave Omar the opportunity to work with and learn from the team of experienced aortic surgeons here. So he gained unparalleled experience of different aortic operations and gained the skills and expertise to carry out life-saving operations. And Omar's now completed the fellowship, and he's joined the team of surgeons here who were his mentors during the fellowship. So the main purpose of Heart Research UK is to fund medical research into the prevention, treatment and cure of heart disease and related conditions. So I just want to tell you a little bit about this medical research project that was funded by Heart Research UK and had the key aim of improving care for patients with aortic dissection. The project took place at King's College London and St Thomas's Hospital, and the researchers were Dr Alberto Figueroa and Miss Alia Nurani. These two researchers brought together their expertise in biomedical engineering and cardiothoracic surgery for the work. So they developed a new technique which combines MRI and computer simulation to study aortic dissection in detail. Using the technique, they can produce sophisticated, accurate virtual models of aortic dissection from individual patients. So they create detailed 3D models of each patient's aorta. Also, it allows them to visualize the location of tears in the intima, which is the inner lining of the aorta, and also to study hemodynamics in the aorta, which is the movement and flow of blood and the pressures inside the aorta. And here in the diagram, you can see an example. So the red arrows show the start and end of the false lumen in the descending aorta. And the colours show the velocity of the blood, with the lowest velocity being blue and the highest velocity is green. In this patient, the false lumen is blocked with clotted blood and has no flow. So the technique may allow patient-specific plans to be made about how and when is best to treat aortic dissection. Importantly, patients avoid the radiation risk of CT scans, which means this is safer. These researchers believe that in a few years' time, MRI will overtake CT for follow-up of patients with aortic dissection. So what's next? The results are promising and further fine-tuning is now underway before this can be used routinely in patients. Alberto is now at the University of Michigan in the US, and Alia is just completing her training as a cardiothoracic surgeon at Papworth. So that summarises what Heart Research UK does in the area of aortic dissection. I just want to end by thanking our AD supporters again on behalf of Heart Research UK, and thank you for listening.